So, I have a challenging programming assignment for you that'll gonna take you a while, but I would like you to implement a multidimensional Kalman filter for the example I've just given you. The matrix class is a class for manipulating matrices that should make it really easy. It has a function that initializes matrices. I'll show you an example in a second. It can set them down to zero. It can compute an identity matrix. It can print out a matrix with show. And it overloads operators like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and even computes the transpose of a matrix. And in some more extended code, it can actually invert a matrix using Cholesky factorization. So there's a function here called inverse. So this matrix class is available. It's a small version of what is found in typical libraries. And I want to demonstrate it for you just for a second. You can make a matrix with a command like this, where the argument in the parenthesis is a two-dimensional matrix. In this case, it's a vertical vector. And with the show command, you can print out the result, a vertical vector. You can compute the transpose as follows. If you run this, you find a horizontal vector. And say you wish to multiply a matrix by a vector, then we can make a 2x2 matrix with this initialization over here, a matrix of 12, 8, and 6, 2. We can print this matrix. Here it is, 12, 8, 6, 2. These are these values over here. And we can multiply f and a. So here b equals f times a. And if we show the result, we get the vector 280. That's obtained by 10 times 12 plus 10 times 8 is 200, 10 times 6 times plus 10 times 2 is 80. So using my matrix libraries, I set an initial state. This is a tracking in 1D where the state is the position and the velocity. I initialize both with zero because I don't know the actual location and the velocity. I give an uncertainty matrix where I have a really high uncertainty in the position and a really high uncertainty in the velocity, and they're both uncorrelated. That's a matrix of 1,000, 0, 0, 1,000. I specify an external motion, but it's 0, 0, so it has no effect, so just ignore this. I build a next state function, which is the one we just discussed, 1, 1, 0, 1. That assumes that the velocity is just being added to the position, and the velocity in expectation stays the same. I build a measurement function that extracts just the first of the two values, 1 and 0, so I can observe the location but not the velocity. I have a measurement uncertainty, happens to be 1 in this example, and I have an identity matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1. And then I run a filter with these three measurements over here. And what should come out is that by running the filter, I can estimate the velocity and therefore make better predictions. In the filter that I want you to program, I want the measurement update first and then the motion update. So every time we run the filter, I want you to update the measurement first, then the motion. So here's my empty procedure filter that you have to fill in, where I go through all measurements and then build the measurement update and then the motion update, the prediction, and then I just print out the resulting estimates. I do this a number of times, three times in this case. And once you fill this in and I hit the run button, I get the following output. After my first measurement update, I observed the location 1, which gets copied over essentially to 0.999 over here, and learn nothing about the velocity. So it's still zero, just the way I initialized it. And then there's an updated uncertainty matrix, which now shows what happens to be a strong correlation. 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, 1,000. That differs from the initial one, only that we filled in the off-diagonal elements. Happens to be exactly what the Kalman filter does. And then when I observe again the two, I want the output to now tell me that my next prediction is 3. It's the observation plus the prediction. But now I have a really good estimate on what the velocity is. It's essentially 1. And the reason is my Kalman filter was able to use the Kalman filter equations to find this value. There's a new covariance matrix. And for the third observation, followed by the prediction is correctly effectively 4, 3.999. Velocity estimate is correctly 1, which is 0.99999, and have yet another uncertainty matrix, which illustrates they have high certainty in the velocity estimate, and also relatively high certainty in the position estimate compared to my initial uncertainties. So can you write the algorithm filter that outputs those exact values over here? This is an involved programming assignment. What you have to do is you have to essentially implement the equations I gave you. You have to familiarize yourself with the matrix class and then go and fill in the filter code in accordance to the things that I showed you for the multivariate Kalman filter.